This matrix vector multiply example gives us a chance to introduce a couple of pseudocode shortcuts. The shortcuts are all based on expressing operations on arrays as vector operations. So you see a hint of that here. Notice the declaration of the temporary array t. I've used this, what's called vector slicing notation. That is indexing with a range of values, in this case 1 to n. Let's see where else we can insert that notation. Let's take a look at this innermost par for loop. What's it doing? Well, it's basically taking a slice of this two-dimensional matrix and multiplying it component-wise or element-wise with this vector x. So I can express this par for loop in a more compact single line of pseudocode. So I basically recognize that all these objects are arrays, t, a sub I, and x. The arrays are all of length n, and they're all indexed in the range 1 to n. Now, this notation is common in a bunch of modern languages. That includes Python, MATLAB, and CoRray Fortran. CoRray who? Now, if the range is the entire range of the array object, then we can replace the explicit range, in this case 1 to n, with just a colon, meaning all elements. So that'll give us an even slightly more compact notation. Let's go ahead and plug that in. And of course, we're all mature enough to see that this vector operation can be easily converted into a parallel for loop. So when you're analyzing pseudocode that includes these kinds of vector operations, just go ahead and use the right work and span. So in particular, these element-wise operations will have linear work and logarithmic span. Now, we'll allow ourselves to use a second simplification, which is to get rid of the temporary array. So it's understood that this element-wise product has to produce a temporary intermediate element-wise result, which we then pass to the reduce. So we can combine these into a single statement. Again, the only subtle thing is that this produces a bunch of intermediate values. So that may require a temporary. So if I ask you to analyze storage costs, then you might need to take that into account.